Good morning, children. Hope you all are doing good and safe with your family members. I am Shilpa Prakash and I'll be taking social studies for 4th grade. So as soon as you hear the word social studies, what comes to your mind? First of all, obviously it is none other than history, right? Okay. So in today's class, I'll be starting with the very first lesson in your social studies subject, the study of the past. As I started with history, my question is, what do you mean by the term history? What is the meaning of that? Many people have defined history in many different ways. To be in the simplest form, history is defined as the study of past events. History, in simple words, it can be said as the study of the past events. Which is connected with a particular person or a thing. So I repeat once again, history is the study of the past events connected with a particular person or a thing. So this is only the introduction part of history what I am giving you now. Now think about an event or a situation or an incident which has happened in your life. Take for example, your birthday party it might be, or the day when you went out with your parents for shopping. You might have asked with your parents to buy this, that for me. They might have rejected. You might have fought with your siblings. All these, to sum up, there are some sweet memories also, there are some sorrows also, isn't it? So what are these? What are we talking about? We are talking nothing about the past. So what is past here? What do you mean by the term past? Past is nothing but the time which has already gone, the time which has already over. Can we go back to the previous day, previous night, or just an hour before? No, it is not possible, is it? So past means the time which has already gone, time which has already over. History is derived from, and also the importance of history and the role played by the people, many great people who brought changes in the society. All these things will be learning in detail after the completion of the lesson. So let me start with the first part of the lesson now, which I am going to talk now is understanding history. To start with understanding history, I would like to tell you, history is derived from the Greek word. I repeat, history is derived from the Greek word. G-R-E-E-K, Greek word. Which word is that? It is historia. His-sto-ria. Sometimes we also say, history is nothing but his story. As it deals with many collection of stories, we do say his story also. Now, what is the meaning of historia then? Historia and history, the meaning is more or less the same. What is it? The study of history in a systematic order, a systematic manner is called as historia. Thank you. one after the other. We cannot study present and we cannot go back to past and understand. It is very much important for us to understand the past and connect it to the present always, so that we can understand past and present in a much better way. So, systematic manner means in an orderly manner, one after the other. Because history is such a subject that it is connected with any number of stories, one after the other, one story leading to another story. So, we need to understand from the beginning. So, it is very much important to study from past to present. As I have mentioned Greek here, I would like to add up one more point. History, the father of history. Who is the father of history? Most of you must be knowing. It is none other than Herodotus. I repeat, Herod, H-E-R-O-D-O-T-U-S, Herodotus. He has been called as the father of history. So, this is all about understanding history. Under understanding history, I started with history has been derived from the Greek word historia, which means the study of past events in a systematic manner, in an orderly way. And then I gave you some information about the father of history. Who is called as the father of history is Herodotus. Okay, let me now move on to the next part of the lesson, that is importance of studying history.
Early humans in the sense means many questions again will arise in our mind.
example, where did they live? How did they live? What did they eat? How were they able to take shelter? Were they living just like us in the houses as we are living? Were they enjoying so much of comfortable life what we are enjoying in the present day? No, they were not enjoying any such things as we are enjoying in today's life. They were making use of the available things in the nature to, and in that way they were able to find their shelter. They first started to live in the caves. Later on, gradually they learned that they can make huts. How did they make huts? They made use of the things available in the nature. Which were the things available in the nature? Were cement bricks directly, was it available for them? As we use for our construction, whenever we construct anything, we do use such things, right? But in those days, those things were not at all there. Then what did they use? They were using stones, soil, mud, clay, barks of the trees, leaves, all these things which were available in nature. They were able to make use of it. And that is how they learned to make their own huts. And gradually, time by time, they thought of making bricks and later on started to build small houses and later on stronger houses. Okay, so this is also one of the reasons that why we need to study history. Let me move on to the next topic, another importance, that is about monuments. Monuments, first of all, the buildings of historical importance are called as monuments. Buildings of historical importance. Buildings of historical importance are called as monuments. What do you mean by the term historical importance then? Historical importance means nothing but something which is very, very important. Something which is very, very valued. When we talk about the monuments, what is the first thing that comes to our mind? Obviously, I hope in your mind it must be Taj Mahal only, right? So, who built it? Everybody knows. Even a first standard going child will answer for that question. Yes or no? It was built by Shah Jahan. Then who is Shah Jahan? I'll come back to that topic when I take another monument to explain for you in detail. Now, I'm going to give you some more information about the monuments. There are many such monuments across the world. Coming to India, we have many monuments which speaks about the glorious past, the rich past. It helps us to understand the connection between the past and the present. How the past and the present? It is mainly because of, it speaks about the artistic, architectural skills of the people who lived during those times. How talented those people were to build such big, huge monuments, beautiful monuments. It talks about their lifestyle, it talks about their beliefs, customs, traditions, values, all such things we are able to learn only because of, not only because of monuments, many things. I stress on monuments once again. So, I'll come back to the topic. We were discussing about Shah Jahan, is it? Who is Shah Jahan? Many of you must be knowing, he was one among the Mughal rulers. Okay, in your textbook it has been given that Red Fort was the official residence of the Mughal emperors hundreds of years ago. I will touch on that point once again. Red Fort, which is in Delhi. Official residence, I told. Official residence. resides in that place, who lives in that place, is called as the official residence. I gave you some information about the Mughal rulers. Who are the Mughals? Who are called as the Mughals? Mughals are none other than the descendants of Babur. You might have heard about Akbar, Jahangir, Shah Jahan, Aurangzeb, and so on. These are all the descendants of Babur. Then, what do you mean by the term descendants? Means the one who lives after you are called as the descendants. So, during the Mughal rule, during the fifth emperor, who was the fifth emperor? I already told you. During the rule of the fifth emperor, it is Shah Jahan. Red fort was built. Construction of the Red Fort started. It was in the year 1639. And Red Fort has its own unique appearance. It was built by using red sandstones, limestones, and marbles, and many other things. So, just I briefed you on the Red Fort. One more important thing I would like to tell you here. Independence Day celebrations, every year it is going to be held in Red Fort. So, monuments speak about the glorious past. So, it is important for us to know about history and its past. I would like to give you some more examples of the monuments. Take for example, Humayun's tomb. Where is it? In Delhi. Bahai House, which is also in Delhi. And then Rashtrapati Bhavan is also one such monument, and so on. In Karnataka, if we take this, we have Mysore Palace as one such example, which is very beautiful in its own way, and so on like that. So, to sum up, monuments also add up to the importance of studying history. Now, let me move on to the other part. Now, I'm going to give you some information about the people, teachers, or the scholars and the leaders, politicians who played their role in the past, who brought changes in the society with their ideas, with their principles. Scholars, I told. I also told about the politicians. Scholars, politicians, teachers, leaders, and so on. Who are the scholars then? Scholars are the people, those who are highly educated. Politicians. Who are called as politicians? What do you mean by the term politician? Means it can be said as a law-making body or members of the government. Members of government or also called as law making body. So, these are some of the people who played an important role in the past and brought changes in the society. There are even social reformers, religious reformers who also brought changes in the society. Take for example, Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Swami Dayananda Saraswati, Miss Annie Besant. All these are the great personalities who played an important role and influenced the people of the past to and brought changes in the society. So, adding to that, how can I forget to tell you about Mahatma Gandhiji? Even Mahatma Gandhiji also played a very important role in India's independence from the British. We all know that. Added to this, there are some events who there are some events added to this, there are some events which brought significant changes in the society. Take for example Republic Day and Independence Day. Why do we celebrate Republic Day? Why do we celebrate Independence Day? It is mainly because India became Republic on Jan 26th. So every year Jan 26th we celebrate Republic Day. And also Independence Day. We got independence from British. That is the reason why we celebrate Independence Day. So each and everything has got its own significance. So there is a need for us to study about history. That is why I stress once again, we need to know about the past. We need to know about history. So let me recapitulate what I discussed in today's class once again. I started with the meaning of history. I gave you the meaning of history and I also explained you what is past. Then I moved on to understanding history, where I discussed about history is derived from the Greek word, and I gave you information about the father of history. Later on, I moved on to importance of studying history, under which I discussed so many points. I gave you information about the early humans, and I gave you some information about the monuments, Red Fort, which is also called as Lal Killa, and I gave you some information about scholars, politicians, and some of the important events which has its own significance. All these things I discussed in today's class. So for today's home assignment, you can write about any three great personalities who lived in the past and influenced people around them. I repeat once again, you can name any three great personalities who lived in the past and influenced people around them. Thank you, children.